Hello everyone, welcome to the video class for the lab simulation practice on MATLAB. Okay, so in this practical we already discussed about experiment 1, so today we will discuss experiment number 10. In this experiment we will discuss about the simulation of half-wave uncontrolled rectifier. This is okay. Simulation of half-wave uncontrolled rectifier. So let's see. So first of all, I just want to tell you that this simulation. This simulation practice on MATLAB. This is for 4th semester diploma electrical engineering student. So let's go to the topic, that is the simulation of half-wave uncontrolled rectifier. So here simulation of half-wave uncontrolled rectifier by using sim power system blocks like your electrical sources, elements, power electronic devices. Okay, these are the elements under the sim power block: electrical sources, elements, power electronic devices. Okay, by using all these sim power system block, we will do simulation for half-wave uncontrolled rectifier. So for this, our equipment required section is the personal computer, operating system Windows 10, then MATLAB software. Here I am using the version R 2018B. okay, this is the version. Then you have to write theory. What you write under this theory, see, you can write about the half-wave uncontrolled rectifier and also related to the simulation blocks. Whatever blocks you are using in simulation, you have to mention the parameters of those blocks. Okay, so in simulation modeling, here we are using the blocks are your AC voltage source, this is one parameter. Okay, and for AC voltage source, our parameters we will set, these are the parameters: peak amplitude is 100 volt, phase degree 0, frequency 50 hertz, sample time 0, measurement is voltage measurement, and then we are using power electronic devices also. So for power electronic devices, we are using diode. These are the, I will show you in MATLAB window also, just go through this. Power electronic device is here diode. We are using half wave, means we are using one diode, and this is the parameter for diode. Okay, these are all I will show you in MATLAB window again. Then we are using series RLC branch, and then we convert this series RLC branch in R load. Okay, R branch. Here our resistance value, we are using 5 ohm. Okay, measurement section, we are using branch voltage, current. Okay, then current measurement, this is the measuring instrument. Okay, current measurement, and here you are using voltage measurement. These two are our measuring element. Okay, then scope. To see the output waveform, we are using scope, and in scope we are applying number of input port is 3. Okay, so these are all. Then for the overall simulation, we are setting time as 0.1 second. So these are all the simulation blocks which we are using in the half-wave controlled half-wave uncontrolled rectifier. Okay, so let's begin with the simulation part. So here this is the simulation modeling diagram. Okay, this diagram we have to implement in the MATLAB. Okay, so let's go to the MATLAB window. This is the MATLAB window over here. So to start a simulation, we need to click in this part, this section, start simulate. So after clicking this, there is initialization of the simulation window. Okay. So then go to the blank model. After clicking in blank model, there is one window is open for creating a model, and then here we need to click this. This is the library. This is the library section, Simulink library browser. From this part we will take all the blocks. So first of all, I want to tell you what is this half wave uncontrolled rectifier. See, the circuit diagram, theoretical circuit diagram, is something like this. This is the AC source, this is the diode, and this is the load section. Okay, here we are using resistive load. You can use RL load, RL0, any load. Okay, so this is the half wave uncontrolled circuit. Uncontrolled means here our power electronics device is the diode. So by using diode, this circuit is named as uncontrolled rectifier, because here output voltage cannot be controlled with respect to input source. Okay, input voltage, output voltage and current cannot be controlled with respect to input voltage. That's why it is uncontrolled rectifier. Because see, when we are giving supply, our supply voltage source is like this. Okay, so in positive half cycle, this point is positive, this point is negative. So during positive half cycle, the diode is forward biased, so current can flow like this. Because in this time the diode is in on or closed state. Okay, but when negative half cycle is appear, like this is negative and this is positive, at that time this diode is reverse biased, and then this is a open circuit. Okay, and then if this is an open circuit, then it is not conducting, there is no conduction of current, and output voltage is zero. So in this case we will get the output like this. That means in positive half cycle we have output, but in negative half cycle we have no output, so it is zero. Again in positive half cycle we have out, in negative half cycle it is zero. Again positive half cycle we get the output, but in negative half cycle it is zero. So in this way we got the output voltage waveform. This is, here we get half wave in one cycle. That's why it is half wave uncontrolled rectifier. So we need to implement all this in the MAT simulation window. So let's go to the simulation part. So this is the simulation window, and here first we need to drag out all the elements. So how to drag out all the elements? Let's see. You need to go to this Simscape. Under this electrical, under this you found a specialized power system. Okay, then under this, see, fundamental blocks, control and measurement, electric drive, fact, renewable. So go to the fundamental block, I think, then electrical sources. Okay, so see, electrical sources means here we got the sources, so we are choosing this one. So press the control i button, then this block is inserted into the window, working window. So source, we got source, then we need element. Okay, for R load we need series RLC branch. Again control I, this is inserted. Then for power electronics, for diode we go to the power electronics section. So here find out the diode, this is the diode. So control I, diode is also inserted. Then we need to measurement. This is measurement. So here current measurement is there, control I. Then voltage measurement is there, inserted. Okay, completed. Power and pulse generator for this, you need anything else or not? No, nothing. But one main thing we want, that is your from power system. If you go to source mode, this is what. Then we need this sources. Click on the sources. What is this? Nothing. Sync, go to sync. In sync you take scope, control I, scope is there. Scope is gone. And you want to power GUI one. So once the whole circuit is done, you need to give power supply. Okay, first of all just draw the circuit. See how we draw the whole circuit. So first source is here, diode is here, then connect this from the source to diode, then this is the resistive load. We need to change this into resistive branch. So here this is RLC, choose the R and value is 5. Okay, then apply, then okay, done. Then right click, then rotate, go to the clockwise rotation. You can use control R button also. So clear. Now join this from source to anode, then cathode to this. Then one more thing, you need to join here current measurement, because for measuring the current we are connecting ammeter in series. So here ammeter, in place of ammeter we are using this current measurement. Okay, done. Then close this circuit. Then for measuring the voltage, output voltage, you need to connect one voltage measurement. Then go to this scope. One scope, you need to delete this one for this scope. First double click in this scope. Then go to this is setting. Here we need to do number of port, input port 3, and layout, we need to do the layout like this. Okay, apply. Okay, so see, these three are the three layout. Okay, so in the first line we need to put input voltage. Okay, so to measure the input voltage we need one voltmeter, also another voltmeter or voltage measurement. So copy this voltage measure and paste here. So this is the voltage measurement for the input voltage. So connect here parallel with this supply voltage, then take to this voltage to this scope. Yes, this is the input voltage. Then the second input port is the output voltage. Then third is the output current. Clear? So just change this. See what is. So here peak amplitude is 100. Make the frequency to 50. apply.
Okay.
And everything is done. Then we need one power GUI. So circuit is now done, but to run this circuit we need to give power supply. So power GUI is the one power GUI here. So to get the power GUI, go to the library and you can search here also. Okay, you can search from this. So we found this power GUI. Okay, from the commonly used block we have this is the power GUI. Drag and drop here. So power GUI, we gave power GUI. Now our circuit is done. Now make it 0.1, then run this. So check this circuit. This is the source, this is diode, current measurement for the output current. This is voltage measure for measuring output voltage. This voltage measurement for the measuring source current. This is the scope is connected here. This is the power GUI is also there. Now see the result. The result is something like this. So check in the MATLAB window. Okay, now the simulation run is completed. Okay, now double click in this simulation window. See, this is your output. This is the supply voltage whose amplitude is the 100 volt. This is the output voltage. In positive half cycle you got the output, but in negative half cycle it is zero. Okay, similar. So because it is a resistive load, so voltage and current, output voltage and current are in same phase. So here the current waveform is similar to the voltage waveform. So this is the required output. Okay, clear? All of you clear? So see, this is the output mentioned here. So this is the all about your single phase half wave uncontrolled. Okay, uncontrolled rectifier. This is your single phase half wave uncontrolled rectifier designing simulation modeling. So go through this video and make your experiment done. Okay, in your record. Okay, go through this video and write the experiment 10 in your record book. Okay, so thank you all.